once you start asking questions, you can't stop.
You see, good health makes a lot of sense, but it doesn't make a lot of dollars. Not considering nutrition seriously, we've done a terrible disservice to all these people.
Every single person in the world, every culture, every language, every country, every person in the world knows it. You are what you eat. Food does matter.
The supermarket. Symbol of the high standard of living in this country today. These products come from farms and ranches despite distance and season. They are the result of a miraculous agriculture, maintaining farm fresh quality all the way to your dinner table.
How old is your food? If you think about it, your food really, in the best of times, is traveling between 1,500 and 2,000 miles before you get it, and is at least a week old, which becomes the next question. How much nutrition value are you getting from food that's at least 5 days old? And if you're lucky, you're getting maybe 40% of what you need.
Nearly every food that you will find in the shops in a big city has been processed, it has been delayed to the shops. Quite often nutrients have deteriorated or disappeared from the food by the time it gets onto the plate.
We, for whatever reason, decided we're gonna spray everything with every kind of pesticide, herbicide, larvicide, fungicide. We decided we're going to genetically modify things we don't know anything about.
And one of the major problems is, of course, the soil and what we do to the soil and the air and the water and everything we take in, our food.
Soils are used and used and used, and nutrients are drawn out of the soils, and the soils become new deserts. And that's happening worldwide. And we do really need to look at our systems of agriculture and what we are really eating and how we're producing food.
The so-called fertilizer is made up of three minerals, N, P, K, nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium. Well, that's nice. But the problem is that the soil requires approximately 52 different minerals. So where's the calcium and the magnesium and the manganese and the zinc and the iron and all of the other things I can't mention? They're missing. But when the soil is deficient, the plants also are deficient and weakened, and they lose their defenses. And the bugs come and attack them, and the disease, the fungus and other disease comes and attacks them. So now they come crying to the chemical company and say, well, our plants are dying and they won't grow and we have pests. And of course the chemical companies are terribly happy to sell them pesticides and fungicides and growth stimulants and all kinds of other things.
Through his intellect, man has developed a superiority over every other form of animal life. From his modern chemistry, biology, and dedicated research have come thousands of effective chemical compounds, all to help revolutionize the productivity of our own agriculture.
So what we are getting, even if we eat just commercial vegetarian food, we get deficient, toxic food. Because with all these pesticides and chemicals and sprays and all of that, the food is not healthy and it's deficient. So we can't help but be deficient and toxic.
And then we cook it. And studies show that even if you lightly steam your food, you're gonna lose the enzymes that are in it.
The simplest thing is that there are live enzymes or live workers inside of foods that help with your body's digestion of foods and the use of the nutrients that are there. So raw food should be a part of everybody's diet.
When you cook food, the immune system reacts to it as a toxin. Most people don't know that. When you cook your food, the body goes through a process called digestive leukocytosis, where it starts generating white cell activity against the cooked food you've eaten, presumably because the cooking process has bastardized the food structure in a way that the body cannot recognize, and so the body is now treating that food as a toxin. That's not a good thing for your body to do to the food that you're hoping is going to nourish you.
There was a Swiss doctor by the name of Paul Kutchkoff, who he was the first to show in the 1930s, that if you ate a diet that was more than 51% cooked food, that your body would react to the food as if it was being invaded by a foreign organism. Dr. Kutchkoff was the first to demonstrate that if 51% of your meals were raw, that you would have no leukocytosis, or you would actually have no white blood cell reaction, so your immune system would not be activated with a false alarm. Because we're dealing with so many immune system issues today, we have to make sure that at least 51% of every meal that we have is raw, so that we don't overburden that already burdened immune system.
How can you build a building that you expect to last 100 years if you put poor building materials in? Same thing with your body. How can you expect your body to last for a long and enjoyable lifetime if you don't put the proper building blocks in there? Everybody knows we are what we eat. If you eat garbage, you're gonna get garbage.
Think of it as chronic malnutrition, because that's what's going on. That's why people are tired. You're not supposed to be tired in the afternoon. You're supposed to be alive and vibrant.